So start the next example, again, which is based on premium. Manish Company Limited issued 20,000 shares each of rupees 8 on a premium rupees 2 per share. Applications were received for 25,000 shares, excess applications were rejected, and allotment were made properly. Share capital payable has ended. This information as usual, there is no change. On application fee rupees 2, on allotment rupees 3, including premium of rupees 2. Means rupees 3 out of rupees 2 as a premium, so rupees 1 as an allotment money. Then first call rupees 3 and final call rupees 2. Company where received except a one shareholder, Mr. Ravi, whom had failed to pay on both call. Again, both call means first and final call. Application is not call, allotment is not call. Call means first, second, third, fourth, fifth, like this. So he had failed to pay on both call means first and final call. So our chart, as for example, company where issued 20,000 share, applications are issued 25,000, there is 5,000 excess application which is rejected by company, means immediately application fee refunded, and allotment where made properly means as per their issue, 20,000 share allotted by company. The face value is rupees 10, 8 and premium amount is rupees 2. And payable as under rupees 2, rupees 3, rupees 3 and rupees 2. Rupees 3 on allotment means rupees 1 plus premium 2, rupees 3. The company were allotted 2000 share to Mr. Ravi, had failed to pay on both call. Both call means first and final call. Is the information given in our example. So journal entries. First, applications are received. Bank account debit, 25,000 applications are received. On each application, rupees 2 is 50,000 received. 2 share application fee account, 50,000. Big application fee received. Next, application fee account debit, 50,000. 2 share capital account, means company want to issue 20,000 share. So, same amount will be transferred to share capital. So, 20,000 multiplied by 2, 40,000. And excess application rejected means that the application fee thereon refunded. So, 2 bank account, 5,000 multiplied by 2, 10,000 means excess application fee refunded. Then allotment, again check the third entry. A share allotment account debit, 20,000 multiplied by 3 means total amount call on at the time of allotment rupees 3, 60,000. But out of rupees 3, rupees 2 as a premium and rupees 1 as an allotment. So allotment money will be transferred to share capital. So 2 share capital account, 20,000 multiplied by 120,000 and premium amount transferred to share premium account. So 2 share premium account, 20,000 multiplied by 2, 40,000. Being amount due on allotment. Then as usual, first call were made, entry share, first call account debit, 20,000 multiplied by 3, 60,000, 2 share capital account, 60,000, being amount due on first call. Amount received, bank account debit, there is Mr. Ravi, who had failed to pay amount on his 2,000 share. So bank account debit, 18,000 multiplied by 3, 54,000. In this example, unpaid calls considered because forfeited the share not forfeited by company. So at that time, the unpaid amount transfer separately transferred to unpaid call account. So entry will be bank account debit 18,000 multiplied by 354,000. Unpaid calls account debit 2,000 multiplied by 3, 6,000. 2 share first call account 20,000 multiplied by 3, 60,000. B amount received except 2,000 share of Mr. Ravi. So final call. Share final call account debit in bracket 20,000 multiplied by 2, 40,000. 2 share capital account 40,000 being amount due on final call. And sale amount not received on 2,000 share and share not forfeited by company. So entry will be passed like this. Bank account debit 18,000 multiplied because amount received on 18,000 multiplied by 236,000. unpaid calls account debit 2000 multiplied by 4000 and to shared final call account 2000 multiplied by 2 rupees 40,000. 20,000 multiplied by 2, 40,000 being amount received except 2000 share of Mr. Ravi. So very simple example. So start the next example. Again, in this example, manually change where many. That is share forfeited by company. In previous example, there is defaulter, but share not forfeited by company. In this example, share forfeited by company. So check this example. Vijay Company Limited issued 10,000 share each of rupees 10 on a premium rupees 2. Means original value rupees 10, premium amount rupees 2. Applications were received for 15,000. Again, there is an excess application means overcall. Company may reject excess application on 2,000 refunded and application fee on 3,000 credited to allotment. This type of information we have already taken in example number 3 and 4. Total excess 5,000 application, out of 5,000 excess application, company where refunded application fee on 2,000 application and application fee on 3,000 credited to share allotment account. So share capital payable as under on application rupees 2, allotment rupees 5, including premium rupees 2 means 5, bifurcation of rupees 5, 3 plus 2. Because rupees 2 is a premium amount, total 5 means 3 plus 5, 3 rupees on allotment, 2 rupees on premium. Then share first for rupees 3 and share final for rupees 2. Company all money was received properly except on a share of 1000 whom allotted to Mr. Raju. He was failed to pay on both calls. Again, same point repeated as per previous example. He had failed to pay on both calls, first and final. But they really changed after final call. His share were forfeited by company. Means in this example, there is no unpaid call account should be opened. So how to solve? So as per diagram, the meaning, exactly meaning of our example, company where issued 10,000 share applications are issued 15,000. There is excess 5,000 application. Out of 5,000 application, 2,000 application free money refunded and on 3,000 were credited to share allotment account. The original value rupees 10, premium amount rupees 2 and call where rupees 2 on application, rupees 5 means 4 plus 1, 5, 4 plus 1, sorry, 3 plus 2. On first call, rupees 3. On final call, rupees 2. Company were allotted 1,000 share. He had failed to pay on first and final call, both call. So how to record this transaction? In journal. So first entry, applications are issued, there on application fee issued, bank account debit 15,000 multiplied by 30,000. Two share application fee account 30,000, big application fee received. Second, application fee transfer, share application fee account 30,000, two share capital account because company want to issue 10,000 shares. So 10,000 multiplied by 20,000. Two bank account 2,000 multiplied by 4,000 means excess application fee on 2,000 refunded by company. And two share allotment account 3,000 multiplied by 6,000 big application fee transfer. Then allotment, share allotment account debit in bracket 10,000 multiplied by 550,000. Two share capital account 10,000 multiplied by 330,000 and two share premium account 10,000 multiplied by 2 means rupees 3 on allotment, rupees 2 on premium. And which is separately credited to separate account, 20,000 big amount due on allotment. Next entry, amount received, bank account debit 50,000, bank account debit 50,000 minus 6,000 because at the time of application, the excess application fee on 3,000 where trading debt to allotment is already 6,000 were received from shareholders. So company were called total 50,000 out of 6,000 already received. So 50,000 already 50,000 minus 6,000 44,000 means bank account debit 50,000 already 6,000 received at the time of application means 44 were received 44,000 to share allotment account 44,000 being amount received. So here it changed 44,000 50,000 minus 6,000 44,000 44,000 being amount received. Then first call were made. Share first call account debit 10,000 multiplied by 30,000 to share capital account 30,000 being amount due on first call. Then amount received. Bank account debit. One shareholder had failed to pay on his 1,000 share. So bank account debit 10,000 minus 1,000 9,000 multiplied by 3. 27,000 to share first call account 27,000 being amount received except a 1,000 share. Then final call were made. Share final call account debit 10,000 multiplied by 2 20,000 to share capital account 20,000 being amount due on final call. Next amount received bank account debit again 10,000 share out of 1,000 unpaid. So 9,000 multiplied by 2, 18,000 to share final call account 18,000 being amount received except 1,000 share. And last entry, the share forfeited. So share capital account debit 1,000 multiplied by 10 means share were forfeited by company after final call means total amount were called with premium. But this shareholder already paid the premium amount. So never consider the premium amount at the time of his share forfeited. So only rupees 10 face value should be considered, premium amount not considered because he had already paid allotment with premium. So premium amount never considered. So share capital account debit 1,000 multiplied by 10,000 to share forfeited account 1,000 multiplied by 5 because he paid application fee rupees 2, allotment fee rupees 3 means total 5,000 to share first call account 1,000 multiplied by 3,000 to share final call account 1,000 multiplied by 2,000 being 1,000 share forfeited from Ravi. So in this entry, premium amount never considered because already Ravi had paid a allotment money, means he had already paid the premium amount. So at the time of forfeited entry, premium amount never considered. It is the main point of this example.